you should hear. Lady Q's in the building, make the noise if you hear. Lift your hands right now.
Hey. Yes, thank y'all so much for hanging out with me today. This is Sunday Flavor in Your Ear, your inspiration conversation, the latest in Christian hip-hop, gospel, and R&B. Yes, today we are continuing the conversation on the five love languages. The one in particular that we have been talking about is gifts, part two. That's where we're at today, gifts, part two. Part one, we learned about the history, and we learned some other important information like how it got started, which is included in the history, and gave some tidbits on that. So we thank y'all so much for listening and tuning in and all those things. And hopefully you were able to click on the link from the show so that you can follow along with the conversation just in case you missed it. okay? All right, so, gifts part two. Okay, so, I don't know if I gave it earlier, but you can hit me up via email, sundaysfire@gmail.com. You can check out my social plats. Yes, my social plats on the gram, Sunday Flavor Host. On Clubhouse, Lady Q Holt, okay? And I'll give you information a little bit later on as things are unfolding and manifesting my new website. Those of you that have been following the page and my different postings, I did a rebrand, and it will be unveiled shortly. Thank y'all so much. Yes, keeping it moving. I am your host for today. Well, every Sunday. I am your host, Lady Q. Staying tuned is the best way to begin your work week, school week, Pilates week, babysitting week, childcare week, however you want to do it, school, because you're teaching, teaching week, however, whatever, whatever your week is, it's the best way to do it because you tuned into Sunday Flavor. I'm giving you the flavor that you need for the rest of the week. You know what I'm saying? Okay. All right, so keeping it moving right along, we'll be back right after this because we're going to slow it down just a little bit. And let y'all get some worship time. And y'all know how we do. Give our first fruits. Get our worship time in. Yes. And let that thing marinate in your spirit. Yes. As Elder Coach used to say. Spirit. Yes. Let it marinate in your spirit. Okay. So we'll be right back after this.
fire, fire, got your feeling lighted, got it. Couldn't keep it to myself, I had to tell somebody. Now I'm repping my Jehovah and I never say I'm sorry. When I step up in the gates, I gotta give them thanks. When I enter in this porch, I gotta give them praise. Ain't worried about a thing, cause I'm walking in faith. Move mountains with my mouth, I believe what I say. Hey, hallelujah, hallelujah. When I think about it, goodness, this is doing something to y'all. So excuse me, bitch, I'm about to keep my shoe up and do my holy dance. All my praise in advance. Hallelujah.
Put your hands to do with good results. I'm telling you, I say that the Lord is pleased with you, that he has placed his name upon your forehead and calls you by his own name. I say that God said if you call upon him the more, that he will bless you the more. I call you blessed. I call you highly favored. I call you a child of the Most High God. In Jesus' name, I speak these blessings on you now. In the mighty name of Jesus, amen.
May your struggles keep you near the cross. And may your troubles show that you need God. And may your battles end the way they should. And may your bad days prove that God is good. And may your whole life prove that God is good. See, may your struggles keep you near the cross. And may your troubles
And we are back. I thank y'all so much for allowing me to share in your worship time. And I thank you for worshiping with me today. Yes, we are going to jump right into this conversation because it is like that. It is hot. The conversation is going to be hot, I'm telling you. So as we are talking about the particular love language called gifts, do you even know or consider where your thought process is when you are buying a gift? Do you even pay attention to that when you're going to buy a gift? What is your thought process? What is the reason that you're going to get the gift? Like, what is the deciding factor that causes you to buy the gift that you're buying? Okay. So what factors are you considering when you're buying? Whatever the mindset you have is at least one of the six you can categorize them in. One of the six. There may be more categories, but I'm just going to give you six of them. Okay? And because a couple of weeks ago, I created a gift mindset survey. Okay? And surprisingly, well, I'll give you that information in after I say this part. It was a really good, sizable response to the survey. And I thank every last one of you that participated in the survey. Some of those answers were hilarious. They were hilarious. And I understand what, you know, where you are coming from with that. Okay. And I just want to give a shout out to the brothers. The brothers jumped right on it. When I made the post, I hadn't even had it up there 5 seconds. I mean, literally, as soon as I clicked post and I came out of that screen or what have you, somebody had already responded. So I just want to thank the brothers for jumping right on in there, because they got stuff to say, ladies. They got stuff to say this year, and they saying it. I ain't posting what they said. Some of them posted it on Facebook, but these brothers got something to say. So I'm just saying, I'm just letting y'all know, okay? All right, so we're going to get into the discussion. I just wanted to give you all a overview of what was said, what could have been said, and all those things. But we're going to play a couple more songs and come right back and get into the meat and potatoes of the survey and the responses, and give you a little bit of information to ponder on as you get through this Valentine holiday. All right, is that all right? That's all right. I know that's right. Be right back.
put together. Gonna let no man put us under. Love like this will stand a storm. Come with it.
All right, and we are back once again. Yes, we are back. So, part two, the gift mindset, okay? Whew, I'm telling you, this is so good. This is so good. Okay, so one of our love languages describes how we receive love from others. That is the gift. I mean, that's what love language is. That is what love language is. It's how we receive love from each other. And in case you didn't know, there's no two people on the face of this earth that anatomically are exact in how they receive or express love. So stop comparing one person to the other person. Well, this one did this, and you're expecting the next person to do that. That's not going to happen. If they don't know their love language, and that's not how they express love in a particular way. And some other factors play into that too. You know, how they communicate, you know, communication goes into how they express themselves. So we'll get into communication styles at another show, but with your love language, you can't compare one person, what one person did, or how you responded to one person to determine how you'll respond to another person. Two different people, two different times, so let it go. All right? So we're going to go over the five love languages, okay? Number one, and some descriptions that go along with that, just for information, okay? Number one, you have words of affirmation. Words of affirmation means saying supportive things to your partner, saying things that make them smile, saying things that make them feel good, that lift their spirit. That's what you're affirming, something in them, okay? They may know it's there, but circumstances sometimes hinder them from expressing that or receiving words of affirmation from you, okay? So just know that. Number two, acts of service. Doing helpful things for your partner, okay? Yes, doing helpful things. So helpful to me might be, you know, taking out the garbage, vacuuming the floor, cracking a toe or two, you know, my back. I'm just saying, not that I need my back cracked. You know, I'm not trying to throw, you know, no hints or nothing like that on my toes. I'm just saying those are things that people might need done. You know, acts of service. You know, you're providing a service for something that I need help with. So it could be stacking some books, washing the dishes, cooking dinner, changing a diaper, picking up the mail at the mailbox, throwing the trash in the dumpster outside, or putting the trash can to the edge of the curb so that the trash man can come by and get it along with everybody else's, instead of me running out at the last minute trying to hurry up and get it out there because I hear the trash man coming in here. I'm sorry. Yes, I done ran with it. It ain't my situation. I just know that that happened. I'm just saying. It's not my situation anymore. Okay. So moving right along. Now we come to receiving gifts. Giving your partner gifts that tell them you were thinking about them. And it doesn't necessarily have to be your partner. So it could be your child, your parent, your coworker, somebody that helped raise you, somebody doesn't have to be related to you at all. Doesn't have to be related to you at all. You know, but they've been a blessing to you in some way, shape, or form. And you're just thinking about them. You know, hey. And I've had that happen to me. People that, you know, bring stuff to the house when I didn't even know they were coming. Hey, I thought about you and I wanted to be a blessing to you. You got to go to work. Bye. I'm just saying. If that person's listening to the show right now, then that person knows exactly who I'm talking to. But it has happened to me several times where people have been a blessing to me. And unknowing to me, I didn't even know they felt that way. Like, you know, I didn't realize how much of a blessing I was to them at that time. Okay, because it is possible to be a blessing to people and you just don't know how much of a blessing you are, and then they be a blessing to you, and it just takes you back a little bit. Okay, quality time. First word is quality time. That's the first word, quality. Okay, spending meaningful time with your partner or another person. Like, okay, my children are grown. Two of my children are grown, and one is not quite grown. She's adulting right now, okay? So, spending quality time for me might be playing Uno with me, you know, or falling asleep telling me about her day in my room, you know what I'm saying? Or we eating at the table or whatever, or we watching a movie together or something. Just to me, that's it, you know, that's quality time, you know? Those things mean a lot to certain people. And quality time to you might be sitting on the sofa watching a football game. Whatever. I'm just saying, whatever it is, you know, whatever quality time is for you, that's your quality time. Spending close moments, you know, together. Talk could be just talking and having tea. Sisters, cousins, you know, aunts, you know, just best friends, you know, just having conversation, just talking, having somebody to talk to that you trust, you know, to some level, all right? And number five, physical touch. Yes, physical touch. Being close to your partner and caressed by your partner. Now, let me clarify that for you single folk. I'm single, I'm just saying. You can be close to someone. Physical touch don't mean inappropriate. It could be you holding my hand when I'm experiencing some kind of emotional whatever. Or giving me a hug. Hey, sis. You know. Let brotherly love continue. Brotherly love, okay, at church. Brotherly love. And a hug at church. And I'm telling you, I know a couple ladies at church. I'm telling you, sisters, I'm telling you, you need a hug. There's a couple ladies at church that can give some good hugs, man. And they feel like your auntie or your mom, especially if you don't have your mom anymore or you don't have that motherly figure around you as much because you've grown and you got to live life. It's nothing like a mother's hug. I'm telling you. One of the mothers at the church, ooh-wee, yes. Ooh, like, ooh, you can just lay on their shoulder, just, ooh, yes, just give it all. You know, you feel so good. Ooh. Okay. And so each of us differs in the ways that we receive love. By learning to give love in the ways that our partner can best receive it. Again, doesn't necessarily have to be a marriage partner. It could be a friendship. So I just want to clarify that. And by asking the other person to give us love in the ways that we can receive it, we can create stronger relationships. You can ask, but you need to know yours and they need to know theirs. So, and yes, so we talk about all that or talked about all that in the class that I taught on the five love languages, which is not available anymore. So, but anyway, yeah, the other person has to understand or has to understand their love language too. So in order for me to get my love language nurtured, okay, I have to speak the other person's love language. And some of us so selfish. We so selfish sometimes. We like, well, I ain't doing it. I don't have to do all of that. Well, that's why you're not getting what you need, because you looking at it like it's all about, well, they did this and they did that. Okay, well, we do things too, so we need to take into account what we do. But again, if you need your love language spoken to you or nurtured, then you need to speak the other person's love language. You have to. It's a must. Everybody's winning. Everybody's winning. They need stuff too. We can't walk around like we're the only ones that need something from somebody. The other person needs something too, so it's a give and give situation. You don't want to take anything. But you give and give. You give, they give. It's a shared experience. Okay? So, we also, the mindset survey. So, the survey that I sent out or I posted, okay, it consisted of six colors. Six color-coded choices, okay? That's number one. And each participant was asked to choose the color that represented their mindset when buying gifts, right? I know. So, in that, that's what they were asked to do. So, I'm going to give you the six colors and tell you what each of them, which question matched each one, okay? So, first of all, the first color was orange. And that question had how long you've been with the receiver. So, if you chose that one, that means your mindset is, when I go to buy a gift, I'm choosing a gift based on how long we've been together. Okay? Okay, and the second one was green. Button number two was green. What the receiver means to me. What the receiver means to the giver. So if I'm buying a gift, what the person I'm buying a gift for, what do they mean to me? I had that mindset when I'm buying a gift. So that's what the green button was for. Okay? And the purple, how much you want the receiver to spend on you. So when it's their turn to buy, when the receiver is going to buy the gift, are you buying your gift now based on how much money you want them to spend on you? Some people have that mindset. And when I was speaking to one of the participants, about the survey, the person had company, and he said, we would have problems if I bought something expensive and they gave me some cheap old whatever. That was his mindset, and he expressed that. That's how he feel. That's where he at in his mind. So, there are people that feel that way. You know, we covered some of that last week, where some people buy gifts because they want you to do them like they're doing you. Okay? But sometimes you got to speak up. If that's not your pocket flow, then don't put yourself out there like that. Don't be looking or acting like you balling and shot calling and you ain't doing nothing but jingling and tinkling. I'm just saying. You know what I'm saying? So you make sure you be transparent and upfront and honest about what you can do. And don't allow nobody to make you go over that if that's not what you want to do or that's not what you can do, because you got to live afterwards. Okay? So the next color was pink. What the gifter liked for themselves. And I've had people to say this, like, well, I like this, so I'm going to get it for so-and-so. Well, like we talked about last week, if you buy the gift because you like it, that doesn't mean that the person you're buying it for has the same taste. So consider that. Be considerate. Well, I liked it, so I think they'll like it. I liked it. No, that's not always true. So you can choose if you want to. Yellow was the next one. What the receiver needed. So some people buy gifts based on what the person needs. If they know that need, then they go and buy it. You know, sometimes they don't know, but they kind of listen for the cues or clues as to what they need. Man, I sure do need this. And just casual conversation, okay? And the last one is the blue, what the receiver wanted. So if the receiver has expressed some interest in a particular item and you pay attention to that, then, you know, you can buy that item. You know, it's good. That's a good one, too. All of these are really good, with the exception of the one buying it because you like it. You figure the other person don't like it. That's not always a good idea. So I don't think it's a good idea at all, but in some people's mind, they feel like there's nothing wrong with that. Okay? All right, so those are the colors, and I did also find out that there are some myths. First of all, the stereotype about shopping that women spend more than men. That's a stereotype. That is a stereotype. They assume, because some of these men out here, hey, they get a Roly and they get these designer sneakers. Hey, one pair of sneakers? Man, look, y'all better know it. We not the only women are not the only ones that spend and invest into their feet. And like I was told by my godfather, he said, look, take care of your feet. You might have to spend a little bit extra coins on your shoes, but you got to take care of your feet because your feet carry you. Okay? And also, if your feet messed up, your back going to be hurting. I'm just saying, I had to learn that. When you have issues with your feet, it's going to mess up your back. But anyway, that's a whole nother story. Okay. All right, so the myths that I found this on csmonitor.com. It's a business website, and they wanted to share some myths about men and women and shopping. So right after this, I'll be right back with the myths that I found, and also the results that were given in Survey Says.
Before you wasn't worth my while.
All right, we are back. Okay, so myth number one. So the first myth, it says men are last minute shoppers. That's myth number one. They said men are last minute shoppers. Men are frequently seen as last minute shoppers. Countless movies and TV shows have shown their male leads frantically searching for an open store on Christmas Eve or Valentine's Day, or showing up with a bad gift because they waited until the last second. But according to a poll that was done, the FAP poll on holiday gifting says that this is just a myth. According to the poll, 75% of men buy gifts for their significant other at least 2 weeks before Christmas. Even the idea of last-minute shopping altogether may be overblown. The poll found only 4% of men and 3% of women put off gift buying. So kudos to you, to those that no longer wait to the last minute. Myth number two, women do the grocery shopping. It may be a bit antiquated, but the belief still prevails. Women do the grocery shopping while men stay at home. In fact, research from the Hartman Group found the opposite is true. According to the report, men visit the grocery store an average of 8.2 times per month compared to 7.5 times for women. Men are also more likely to visit club stores like Sam's Club or Costco than women. Okay? So that's another myth. Myth number three, women spend more time picking out gifts. It is commonly believed that women spend more time carefully picking out gifts while men are more likely to ask the recipient what they want or just wing it. But the same poll, FAP poll, suggests the contrary. Of the 3,000 consumers polled, 46% of women were more likely to ask their significant other what they wanted directly, while only 40% of men are likely to ask. Myth number four, men don't shop for grooming products. Well, that's not true. It isn't that men aren't unwashed, they just don't normally shop the hygiene and grooming aisles. They get a woman to do that for them, hence ads like Old Spice and The Man Your Man Could Smell Like, which targeted women shopping for men. But in fact, grooming and personal care lines tailored specifically for men are one of the fastest growing markets in the beauty industry, and the study by the NPD Group found 9 out of 10 men use at least one grooming product, while 37 have used a facial care product and 30% have used lip products. Myth number five, men research, women impulse buy. Okay, so women are more likely to fall in love with an item and buy it, while men like to plan out their shopping trips, right? Not necessarily. A study from the Future of Commerce found 82% of shoppers, both women and men, use consumer review sites to research a product before buying it. I know, right? So, myth number 6. Women buy more than men. I don't know. A study conducted by the Business Insider Intelligence found that when it comes to online shopping, men spend as much as women, and men are more likely to make purchases on smartphones or tablets. A willingness to shop more online may have something to do with how men perceive shopping. Many studies have shown men prefer to shop quickly with a goal in mind, something that might be easier to do when you can quickly search for what you want from the comfort of home. While men and women often play different roles when it comes to household shopping, many of the things we believe to be true about the opposite sex aren't really true at all. And all of us really like to shop, especially online. So there you have it. There you have it. Men and women like shopping online. Men and women go to the grocery store, and more men are at the grocery store than women. Now, I mean, I think it's this. The men that have a spouse at home or lady at home, they're trying to share the experience, or whether it's voluntary or involuntarily, you know, or the woman has asked, hey, can you go to the store and pick this up? Can you go to the store and pick that up? Whichever it is, they're doing it. Okay? They're doing it. So we don't have to do everything by ourselves. All right? So I will be back because we are right here at the Survey Says. Yes. But I'll be right back after this.
I used to think that I wasn't fine enough, and I used
And survey says, ping. That's my button for survey says, okay? So, yes, we are back. So, as I mentioned, I gave all the colors, okay? The orange, the green, the purple, the pink, the yellow, and the blue. Yes, there were some awesome responses. And between Facebook, Messenger, and my regular message box, it was very, very good to see people sending their responses and didn't mind explaining why they felt like they felt or why they had the mindset or whatever the experience was, they had no hesitation on participating. So I wanted to thank them for that. So for the orange button, which was how much time that person that person spent with the person, that's the mindset they had, okay, 10% chose that button. Yes. Buys a gift based on how long I've known the person. Okay, the green button was buy a gift based on how I feel about that person or what that person means to me. Okay, so we want to say 50%. 50% chose that button, the green button. Okay, yes. So that was like the largest, section. So, and what got me was the men chose, were the first ones to respond to the survey, and they're included in that number, that percent. Yes. Go men. All right. Button number three said, the mindset was, I am going to purchase something in the amount of money that I want somebody to spend on me. Okay, that percentage was zero. Zero. Nobody chose that one. Now, unless they're telling stories, because I've heard people say, well, I want them to spend this amount of money on me, so I'm a spend that amount. Okay? So nobody chose that. So that's good, right? Button number four was the mindset of purchasing an item because they liked that item. Okay. 30% chose that. 30% chose that. Yeah, they buy stuff based on what they think they like. Or some people said that, well, if I know the person, and I pick something that I know they would like. So that went into that number. Button number five was the yellow button. Also 30% picked that one as well. Yes, they did. They picked that one as well. And that was really good. So they get stuff that the person needs. They get stuff that the person needs. So that was really good response. And button number six. Yes. Button number six was getting something that they wanted. They listened to the cues, the clues, the suggestions, the hints, whatever. And they, the mindset that they had was to buy what the person said that they wanted. They said they want to buy a gift that, hey, if you want it and I get it, then I know that you like it, you know. So that was button number six. And I thank y'all so much for playing along with us on Survey Says. And we're going to have some more things coming up or whatever, for you all to participate in. So I just want to thank y'all so much for doing that. This was really, really awesome. Really, really awesome. So with that being said, we're going to play some more music and come right back and holler at you for a couple more minutes. And yeah, you all enjoy the show. Yep, don't forget, hit me up. Hit me up in my email and on my social plats and all of those wonderful things, and we'll be right back. We are back, we are back. Y'all know what time it is. Y'all know what time it is. I thank y'all so much for staying tuned. I thank y'all for hanging out with me. Y'all, I thank you all for participating in the survey. Yes. So we talked about the stereotypes. We talked about the myths that people have with gift buying. Go to psychologytoday.com and you'll see the 5 love languages definitions and examples on that page. So www.psychologytoday.com and look up the 5 love languages, or you can just Google 5 love languages definitions and examples, and it'll pop up right there on Google. But it's on Psychology Today's website, so definitely check that out. And also the other website that I gave you for, let me go back and find it. Oh, the csmonitor.com, the business, the 6 myths about how men and women shop. Definitely want to check that out as well. All right. As always, I thank y'all so much for hanging out with me today. Don't forget your monetary support and sponsorship via Cash App. Yes. $SundayFire. PayPal, SundayFire@gmail.com. Send all emails to SundayFire@gmail.com. Look me up, Sunday Flavor Host on the gram. Please don't snide no sneaky links into my DM. Please don't do it. All right. And Lady Q on Clubhouse. And also, stay safe. Take care of each other. And until next time, next week, we're going to be talking about something else. And I'm telling you, we're just doing some big things, some new things. Let me know how y'all like the new music. If you've heard it before, enjoy the holiday. Love on each other. Take care of each other. And be safe. I'm out. Peace. Do do do.
your ears, got the fire you should hear. Lady Q's in the building, make the noise if you hear. Lift your hands right now, right now.